guys, welcome to Techgear TV again. 大家好 ，Salam sejahtera. 今天 we are gonna take a look at colorful laptops. So you're wondering why I'm mixing languages here? Because the colorful laptops are from China, and they're not usually sold outside of China. But their recent days, they have been selling their products outside of China, and it's been getting some attention. Okay, so we have two models of laptops here. We have the box right here. So the box is nothing fancy. It looks like this. Okay.We already got the laptops outside the box. I have the i5 model here and the i7 model here. So we have two models to look at. Okay, so this is how the laptop looks like from the front. I mean, depends how you see it, but this is the front for me. And this is the back. So at the back, you can see a lot of ventilation holes at the bottom. So this is the i5 model. With the i7 model, there's actually more opening at the bottom for more air, for better cooling. And I think it actually works out.So at the side, on the left side, we have two USB ports and two audio jack, interestingly. So not only they have a mic jack, they also have a headphone mic combo jack. And then at the back, we have the charging port. We have a Type-C charging port, a display port, a mini display port, and a HDMI port. So with the mini display port, if you plug it in into a, let's say a G-Sync monitor, a gaming monitor from MSI, Gigabyte, Asus, you can actually enable G-Sync from the NVIDIA control panel itself. And then on the left side, did I say left or right? I don't remember, but on the other side, we have a LAN port, yet another Type-C port, and a micro SD card. So with the LAN port, it's a bit weird, because it's a mini RJ45 port, and we don't usually use that. RJ45, this is the regular port, and this is the mini port. As you can tell, it's slightly smaller. It's also got 8 pins, but it's slightly smaller. It's like USB-A versus micro USB. So this is the i5 model at the bottom. I'm not sure if you guys can see it, but the i7 model, you can see that there's more holes at the bottom. Yeah? All right. Okay, so back to the left side of the i5 model. It's got the same I/O, one USB 3, one USB 2, mic jack, headset jack. At the back, we're missing one Thunderbolt jack, which is only on the i7 model. And then charging port, HDMI, and the mini display port. So mini display port is the one that I recommend for you to use if you're gonna use an external monitor. And then on the other side, you get a regular LAN port, which is great, another USB 3 Type A port and a Type C port, and a full size micro SD card slot. Now let me show you the charging brick. All right. Thanks. Okay, so this is a charging brick. It's 150 watts charging brick from Chicone. So it's pretty standard. And this one is particularly slim. It's not heavy. I would say it's a few hundred grams. But for Wi-Fi, they both have Intel AX201, which is Wi-Fi 6 compatible and comes with Bluetooth 5, which is great. Okay, so let's move on to the RAM capacity. 8GB on the i5 model and 16GB on the i7 model. They are both rated 3200MHz. Nothing too special about that, standard these days. Okay, so for the i5 model, the expansion for the storage is also a bit different. The i5 have an extra port for 2.5-inch drive. So you can either put a 2.5-inch hard drive or you can put a 2.5-inch SSD drive. For the i7 model, however, it doesn't have that expansion capability. It's got an extra M.2 NVMe port instead. So let's say if you have a 2.5-inch lying somewhere, you're not going to be able to put it in there. You got to buy a new NVMe drive and expand that. Okay, so that's the difference between the two. The first thing I tested was the screen accuracy. They're both rated 144Hz. And I tried gaming on them. They're pretty smooth, they're pretty nice. What I really have a problem with is with the color. So I calibrated them and measured them. They're only 57% sRGB accurate. So maybe for color critical work, I wouldn't recommend this. But for gaming and everything else, entertainment, Netflix consumption, these are great machines. Okay? All right. And then we have Cinebench comparison. I also did the Cinebench on the AMD Ryzen 5 3600 desktop CPU. The result is here. So it's gonna be really interesting to look at. As you can see, the i7 tops the chart, and it's a mobile chip too. So the i7 tops the chart around 13,000 points, and the Ryzen 3600 actually scored around 9400 points, which is in between the i5, which is around the i5 score. So the i5, I tested it twice, once factory settings and then another time with an extra 8GB of RAM to give a dual channel performance, but I don't think that actually affects the Cinebench scores a lot. What actually made the difference was the changing of the thermal paste. So I took out the heatsink assembly and I changed the thermal paste, and the everything actually got slightly cooler, and then the thermal throttle was a little bit less worse. So it actually got the score up to around 9,900 points, which is actually higher than the AMD Ryzen 5 3600 with a third party cooler. Think that. So people who are doing video works, Photoshop works, but you don't really mind about the color accuracy, this is actually a really good deal. Alright, the i5 machine. And then the i7 is another story actually. The i7 is like balls out performance. So for gaming wise, I tested three games. So we did Apex, COD Warzone, and Valorant. So Valorant's pretty easy to run, and then Warzone's slightly harder to run, and then Apex even harder to run. So for the i5 models, I also did two tests. One with 8GB of RAM, which is the stock settings, and then another one with 16GB of RAM and repasting it with what I think is a better thermal paste. The ID Cooling IDTG25. These are actually pretty good thermal paste, and they usually comes free with every ID Cooling heatsink purchase. And these are the performance that you can see. So I'm gonna show you the i5 stock performance first. As you can tell, it's not that great. You're getting like slightly over 60 frames, okay? But the screen's offering 144Hz, so you know we're not getting the full use of that screen. And the first time I tested it, I quickly found out that it's probably got to do with the fact that it's only got 8GB of RAM. Not that 8GB's not enough, but 8GB in single channel, it's not in dual channel. So you're losing out a lot of speed right there. So I open it up, I swap out the thermal paste, and then I added another 8GB of RAM. And you can see the performance again. So almost all the games here, they increase over the chart by around, I would say, 10 to 15 frames. So the performance increase is from anywhere from 15% to 40% actually. So that is very significant. So if anyone's going to buy this laptop, I will highly recommend you that you add another 8GB extra RAM for you to make good use of the laptop. All right, so now we're gonna look at the i7 model performance. The i7 performance is a bit different from the i5 models because it's got an RTX 3060 as compared to the i5 model with the RTX 3050. All right, so let's look at the chart here. We're gonna look at the performance itself by the i7 model first. So you can see really high performance, very low 1% low FPS and very high minimum FPS. If you can look at it, most of the games here are running around 144 frames and above average. So it's actually making really good use of all the screen 144Hz refresh rate here. We're gonna compare the i7 model with the i5 model after an additional 8GB of RAM, meaning 16GB of RAM, and then with the repasting of the thermal paste. So as you can tell, the performance difference between the 3060 and the 3050 is actually quite significant. For every game, you're looking at the difference of anywhere from 40 to 100 frames, depending on which game you play. So that's an easy 50% to 100% performance difference there. So the i5 model is only currently going for $3,999. For that price, I would say that's a very good price to performance ratio for the laptop. So if you want to do mobile work, you want to go around, get work done, I think this is the machine. With an extra 8GB of RAM, it would cost you around 4,200 ringgit, which is less than $1,000, okay? And then for the i7 model, it's selling for 5,599 ringgit. So that is about 1,600 ringgit more, but it comes with, by default, 16GB of RAM and an RTX 3060. However, the 3060 doesn't help with work that much, but with gaming, it makes a significant difference. Due to the performance and the extra 2GB of VRAM. Alright, so that's it for the review. And if you guys are interested in the laptop or you guys want to check it out, you guys are welcome to come to Techgear Malaysia, which is located at Connaught Cheras. Or you can Google us up on Google Maps and search for Techgear Malaysia. You can come up and check out the laptops for yourself. And if you don't want to check it out, you feel like this is the right purchase for you, you guys can buy it directly from us. message us on Facebook, Techgear Malaysia, or you can message us on Shopee, Techgear Malaysia as well. Okay? That's it for today, guys. Thank you for watching. Subscribe and like. Comment down below what you guys want to see next. See ya.